Hello, I'm Keith Hilston with the Schmidt Music Trombone Shop, back with another instrument review for you. And today, I've got an instrument that I'm really excited about, specifically the S.E. Shires Marshall Gilkes Artist Model Small Bore Tenor Trombone. This is a horn I've actually heard about for a little bit here. We had a little bit of an inside track with S.E. Shires, but of course we couldn't say anything until anything was officially announced here. But we have actually one of the first available here in the shop. I've had a chance to spend some time with this really, really awesome horn, who of course, one of the best makers out there, S.E. Shires, has developed with one of the greatest jazz trombonists out there right now, Marshall Gilkes. It's a really, really great combination, and I'm really excited to share it with you. So I'm going to take a play on it so that you can hear it afterward. I'm going to be playing all of this on my trusty Bach 7C. Thank you. Like I mentioned before, this model is really a collaboration between two of the best folks or teams really out there in the brass world, in the jazz world, namely S.E. Shires and Marshall Gilkes. If you haven't had a chance to check out Marshall's work, please do yourself a favor and do it as soon as possible. The work that he has continued to do over the past decade plus is just astonishing. Somebody who's really recognized as being on the forefront of the instrument, not just in jazz settings, but just in overall technique and accessibility, the range, the flexibility he has is just off the charts. It's amazing. And so when I started hearing rumors about Shires building a custom horn with him, of course, I was really, really excited about it. So there are a number of features with the new Gilkes model, which of course are really interesting right off the bat. First of which being it has a cut bell. This is the first artist model small bore tenor cut bell that Shires has offered here. So the overall setup, so this has got their Marshall Gilkes bell. So again, this is a cut bell. It's a 7¾-inch bell, all yellow brass, a fairly heavy rim on it, if I might say so, which I think will lend to some of the playing attributes that we'll talk about in just a minute here, along with, of course, the cut bell, gold brass on the collar. It has a T1 tuning slide, and one of the things I really love about both the bell and the counterweight is it has this wonderful Marshall Gilkes specific engraving here. We've got kind of the mountain motif. I've always loved the engraving that Shires has done, and I think this just really, really reflects the unbelievably cool nature of this instrument. So they paired the bell section with a 500-bore Marshall Gilkes specific hand slide here. So it's a 500-bore standard yellow brass outer tubes, nickel silver crook, yellow brass over sleeves. I like it compared to some of the other Shires small bore tenor hand slides. I feel like it has just a little bit different heft to it in a way, but it's still really flexible, versatile, which we'll talk about in a second here. And typically this model, of course, it's going to come with a couple of different lead pipes. We had with it the 2.5 and the 3.0 T0 lead pipes, and for me those made a real difference. So I don't know, hopefully this comes across in the recording. This is an unbelievably complex, dense sounding instrument. The best analog I can think of for it is the old Con 6H, for example. Compared to other lighter weight models, especially a lot of the smaller bore tenors we see right now tend to be a little bit lighter. The Con 6H has always been renowned for still having a really, really, warm sound to it. Not necessarily a softness, but a warmth to it. This has some of that, but much more complex than even I think the 6H was, and still I think more articulate, more flexible. The timbre of this, what I really love about it, throughout the range of the course, it has the real Shire stability in terms of timbre, in terms of response. When I start pushing the dynamic with it, you can get a little bit, I don't know if I'd even say brightness or brilliance, you can get a little bit of punch to it, but it still stays extremely stable. It doesn't get edgy at all, but you can get, again, a little bit of a growl, a little bit different timbre out of it, but still maintains so much of that beautiful, dark, complex character to it. Now, the really interesting thing is I think this combines it with an unbelievably flexible instrument. Again, going back to Marshall's needs, this instrument from bottom to the top, it moves effortlessly. The slotting on it is unbelievable, especially as we start to get into those really close partials You know, in 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, where everything slots in is beautiful. The 12th partial sitting up there, the E-flat, E-natural, F, it sits up there as well as any horn I have ever played and still stays, again, nice and warm and open. And well, sometimes you can have instruments that sit up there, but you have to compact the sound down a little bit. You have to compact the airstream to make it happen. With this instrument, it just sits right there. It's really, really approachable, which I absolutely love. I mentioned the couple of lead pipes. We have the 2.5 and the 3.0 that came with our first model here. Initially, when I played the 2.5, I liked the horn. I found it to be a little bit on the small side. I, as many of you know, I'm a King 3B player. I tend to like a little bit more open setup or a setup that balances some of that airflow. So for me, the 2.5 combined with the 500 hand slide and the 1.0 tuning slide was just a little compact. As soon as I put the 3 lead pipe in, all of that changed. The response opened up for me. I felt like I had much easier access to the upper register. I felt like I had better control and articulation, more stability with my sound from the front, middle, end of it. Just a much more responsive, much more enjoyable instrument. This is one of those horns where I just wanted to keep playing it, just wanted to keep recording because it was just such a blast to play. And of course, along with all of these unbelievable benefits here, you do get the transport ability with the cut bell as well. We've talked about cut bells before, and I think the cut bell nature of this, the weight, the denseness that it gives, you know, with having that collar on there, I think really does play a role in how this instrument plays. Gives it, you know, some of that, again, that warm, dense, stable character. But of course, it makes it imminently transportable as well. And as many of you may have seen, Shires, as of this year, has transitioned into Marcus Bona cases for all of their custom instruments. So this, of course, comes with the SE Shires Marcus Bona model cut bell case, which if you've seen those unbelievably compact in with all of the unbelievably classic Marcus Bona styling. So they're, you know, they're lightweight, extremely protective, extremely portable. Comes with an SE Shires 6.5AL mouthpiece. These are, of course, mouthpieces that they're building with Pickett. So you're really, from all directions, you're getting some of the best of the best of the best happening all in one package here. So I love it. This is a wonderful instrument. I think it's a wonderful addition, a different addition to the small bore tenor world than anything I think we've had in quite a while. And I think it's a really exciting collaboration that is going to be, again, a wonderful addition. So I hope you enjoyed my review here. If you have any thoughts about what you heard, your experience, maybe you had a chance to play one of these already. If you have questions about what I experienced, the setup, any of that, please feel free to leave them in the comments. I and the other members of our community would love to engage in a conversation here. Of course, if you haven't already done so, think about giving this video a thumbs up. Think about checking the other videos out on the channel. Think about subscribing to our channel so you can find out whenever we have new videos coming your way. Hit that notification button so there they have them coming to you. And of course, as always, you can find us on Facebook and Instagram. So thank you very much as always for watching.